Have you ever been so broken and so wounded by the breakup of a relationship that you didn't know how you would even ever recover? We've all been there. So in today's video, I am going to share my 5 top tips how to recover from a breakup from anyone, anytime. So go ahead, grab your coffee, grab your tea, grab your girlfriends, and let's talk about these 5 things that I think every person needs to use to get over any breakup. Hey, single queen, it's your girl, Coach Cheryl, and welcome to my channel. In this channel, we talk about everything that's gonna cause you to become engaged, active, and excited about your life. Yes, we know that God is going to bring your king someday soon, but until that time, on this channel, we're gonna learn about how to build big business, how to deepen our relationship with God, how to actually have big fun and get our money, credit, finances, all the way together until he comes. So if this sounds like content that you would enjoy, I'm gonna ask you to join the family. Hit that subscribe button. Also remember to click that notification bell so that you'll know when I drop a new video. Now, most of you watching this video have experienced heartache, heartbreak, that kind of trauma. And it's never easy to walk through that. I can remember several years ago meeting an awesome young man who I thought was, and girls, y'all know, y'all can feel me, the one. Has anybody ever had that experience when you met someone and you finally thought, oh, you know, permission to exhale? I found the one. He was an incredible guy. We had so much in common. We enjoyed each other's company. Our families got along, and so we just knew that we would be together. In a short span of time, we started talking marriage and family and everything that goes with that. So you could imagine my surprise after just a few months in, nothing seemingly being wrong with the relationship, nothing seemingly being wrong, where boom, we hit a brick wall, and he decides that he doesn't want the relationship anymore, or that the relationship is moving too fast and that I don't seem to be the person for him. How devastating that can be. I can still remember where I was sitting on my bed the night we had the telephone conversation where we officially broke up. I can remember hanging up that phone and just weeping. And my sister was in the other room. And so I'm thinking to myself, I know she hears me, so I gotta go tell her. And so I walk out and I tell her, hey, out of the blue, we just broke up. And I can remember her looking at me and telling me, you'll be okay, you'll be okay. And I can remember going back into my room on that evening and sitting down and praying to God. I don't even know if you could call it a prayer. It was a conversation that I had with God, and it was a brief conversation. And I just said to him, I don't know what to do. I feel like my heart is broken into so many pieces that I don't know how to recover. Because see, I'm the kind of person that I'm always helping other people recover. I'm always, you know, when something happens to me, I'm going to fix it, I'm going to make it better. But in this situation, I didn't know what to do. And so I say to God that night, I am giving you every single piece of my broken heart. My heart is shattered into so many pieces, God, I can't even figure out where they are. So I know I can't fix this. I know I can't heal my heart. So here are the pieces I could find. Here are the things that I know are broken. And so I'm just going to trust you and ask you to put this heart back together again so that I can feel normal again, so that I can feel okay about me again somehow, some way. And through the span of weeks and months, and dare I say years, God just start massaging and mending my broken heart. And so I want to take you through the 5 things that God walked me through that helped me heal my broken heart. And I hope and I pray, my dear queen, that these are things that will help you too. The first key to mending a broken heart is to bring God into the process. bring him into that space where you are hurt, where you are broken, where you are wounded. Invite him in. Because of a truth, I know nothing and no one can heal like Jesus can. I know a lot of times we just relegate different kinds of physical healings to God, but I don't know anything, any source that can heal an emotional, mental wound like the power of Jesus, like the power of God, like the power of the Holy Spirit that came in and almost sat on my heart and covered me while I healed during that process. So sister, I'm gonna ask you to invite God into this healing process. Do not dare try to do this on your own. Invite him in. The second thing that helped me during my healing process was admitting I was hurt. And I know that sounds so simple, but as I mentioned, I'm such a resilient person and I'm always the healer for other people. I'm always the encouragement for other people that it was often hard for me to admit, okay, I'm broken, I'm wounded. This right here has taken me for a loop. And so I had to step outside of my superhero, superwoman persona and admit I couldn't change this. I couldn't fix this. There was something I needed outside of me to help walk me through this. So admitting I was hurt, admitting not just that I was hurt, but that I couldn't fix it, and this was something that God had to fix for me, that he had to help and walk me through, was huge for me because it allowed me to be vulnerable. It allowed me to step back out of leadership and step back and give control to God for the healing process. That includes the timing of it, how long it took me to heal. So when I stepped back and I really gave this to God and admitted I was hurt, admitted I was wounded, only then could I allow God and other people to help me through the process. The third thing that I had to do was reject self-shame. I'm gonna say that again because I want you to hear that. I had to reject self-shame. I had to stop making myself responsible just for being hurt. Like it was a bad thing, like having loved someone and not having that reciprocated in the way that I wanted to was a bad thing. God had to show me that I had huge capacity for love and maybe someone couldn't handle the capacity that I had, but that was okay. There was nothing shameful about me loving someone. There was nothing shameful about me wanting companionship. There was nothing shameful at all about that. Yes, I was in a relationship. Yes, it didn't work. Yes, I got wounded. Yes, I got hurt. There was nothing shameful about that. So I want to speak to the woman who has been in a situation, who has gotten hurt, and now you feel ashamed. Maybe because people around you knew. The relationship that I was in, it was public knowledge. Everyone knew we were dating, and they would often ask. And so a part of my shame was, what am I going to tell them now? We're not together anymore. So how was that going to make me look? How was that going to make me feel going through that breakup? And so I had to begin to, you know, reject shame for that. Yes, we were together. And yes, it's over. It didn't work. And be okay with that fact and not shame myself, not blame myself because it didn't work. So sister, do not shame yourself. Do not feel embarrassed because you had huge capacity to love and you were willing to share that love with someone else. No, it may not have worked, but in life we know everything doesn't work, but at least we gave the opportunity for it to work. And so now I want to ask you a question. What are some of your biggest lessons from a breakup? How has God walked you through that process? How did he help you heal from that? I want to hear from you in the comments. Help other women that are also watching this video. Help them see some of the tips, some of the strategies that God has given you so that we can all learn and grow and help each other through traumatic situations. And so let's continue with our list. And so number four, I want you to give yourself time to heal. Yes, give yourself time and space to heal. I think that was one of the most important things for me, was I didn't try to rush into a relationship to kind of, how some people do, to heal that empty space that you were used to sharing with someone else. And so I took years off from even dating people because I wanted that time and space to make sure that I had a clear head and that I had a clear heart and that my picker got better. That I wasn't picking people based off occupation, based off looks, based off they were just saved and they love the Lord, because we know unequally yoked is not just a person that is saved or unsaved. You can be unequally yoked with a believer, but learning how to see, does our lives match? Does our destinies, are we walking in the same place? So give yourself space to heal so that subjectively you can start seeing warning signs and red flags. Remember, we just talked about red flags on last week, and that video is there. If you did not see it, I need you to go check it out after we finish here so that you can notice red flags, because God start taking me back through that relationship and say, see this red flag I showed you here? See this red flag I showed you here? There's another red flag I showed you here, and you just glossed over it. So make sure you watch that video and make sure that you allow yourself time to heal so that you can go over that relationship and see your part in the demise of the relationship, because it's not always just the other person. We also have to admit that we played a role in the dismantling of a relationship as well. And so let's close this out with the fifth key to make sure that you heal and recover from a breakup. And that's trust God with your heart and with your life. I was at a point where I was trusting the men that I was dating with my heart, instead of trusting God with my heart and asking the questions that I needed to ask before I entered into relationship. And so now I approach relationships much differently. I don't give a man my heart. My heart belongs to God, and then God can steer my heart in a direction that is safe, in a place that will, or in a person that will see that heart and see the access to that heart as a privilege and be careful with it. And so I gave my heart to God, and I became open to dating and to seeing other men, because now I knew that they didn't have the capacity to hold my heart like that, that God had my heart like that. And if I trusted God with my heart, this is God, my heart is in His hand, that He would steer and He would direct me to people that I could trust, and then He would steer me away from people that I could not trust. So He started bringing men and just friends into my life and said, this is a safe place for your heart. This is not a safe place for your heart. Don't even get entangled. Sometimes He would even let me get entangled with friendships with people He knew that weren't a safe place for me. He said, this man appears this, but he is toxic, steer away. You can't even have a friendship with him. You can't even have an acquaintanceship with him. Steer away, he is toxic. And a lot of times people didn't understand, as they would present men to me, and then my sensors would just come alive, and God would say, no, not even a friendship, not even acquaintanceship. I don't want you to have anything to do with that. This person is toxic, move here. And learning how to trust God, even when I hurt other people, people that loved me, that wanted the best for me, I had to be true to the voice of God on the inside of myself. And so I stopped trusting myself. I stopped trusting other people. Some other people, there are some people I trusted, but God would just show me, here, not here. Yes, no. And over time, I learned how to be in tune with the direction that God had for me. So I hope these simple five tips have helped you. And I want to reiterate them just so that you will have them. Number one, make sure you bring God into the process. Number two, admit your hurt. Number three, reject self-shame. It is no shame that you have great capacity to love, queen. Just protect it. Number four, give yourself time to heal. And number five, trust God with your heart and with your life. And as I close today, I have compiled a great resource, which is called Rules of Engagement. And for a short time, I am offering it to ladies in this community for free. If you see, there is a link in the description box where when you sign up for our email list, you will get this ebook that gives you 7 tips, tools, and principles for living life abundantly. It's called The Rules of Engagement. I believe every woman should have it. If you'd like to get that free resource, again, make sure that you check the description box where you can avail yourself to it. And if you've been with me this long and you have yet to subscribe to this community, I'm going to ask you to join the family. So go ahead and click that subscribe button. You'll see that there is a little icon, a picture of me. Just click that. Also, make sure that you touch that notification bell so that you'll know when I drop a new video. And if you are a single woman and you're believing God to bless you with your king, I want you to look at the videos here that will also provide you with tips and tools and strategies on how to live here just a full life while you wait for God to bring that man to you, and also here to give you strategies and things to look away from, how to build yourself in the meantime. I love you all with the love of the Lord, and I look forward to seeing you next week. God bless. Make sure you share this with somebody. Don't let your single girlfriends be out there by themselves. Invite them into this community. God bless you.